So we're in the Everglades during the dry season. That means that water can be a little bit scarce and far and few between water holes. But a pretty easy way to find them here, if you should find yourself lost, if you should wander off trail for some reason or get confused, pretty easy way to find it is just to look at the local vegetation. The pines, for example, if you look at some of these big pines over here on the other side of the trail, those pines like dry land. They can't really survive in the water for very long other than really short periods of time. But these plants here, these cypress trees love having their feet in the water, essentially. So if you look at large clumps, large, I guess, what would you call it? What do they call them around here? Hammocks, I think is what they refer to them as around here. A large hammock of cypress trees that are growing really thick in close proximity to one another. That is probably going to be a wet spot. And there's another thing that we can look for. Hopefully you can see it on camera, but this is a game trail going off of this main trail that we're walking on. This game trail almost certainly leads to a water source. That can do several things for me. It can give me some water to drink. If I was dying of dehydration, it's gonna be kind of scummy, nasty water this time of year, but it's better than dying of dehydration. If you have a way to filter it, boil it, and all that stuff would be ideal. But even if you didn't, I would drink it over having nothing else. But there's also going to be something I could possibly eat over there. Any fish, something like that. Usually the small pools are gonna have frogs, they're gonna have tadpoles, tiny fish, things are gonna be easy to catch and scoop up. So let's go check it out and see if we can confirm what, and maybe some alligators. Who knows? You want to fry some alligators up? Some alligator leg or alligator tail?
It's a little more outlined right here. You can see the trail.
Another wonderful thing about these thickets of cypress trees is it's a little bit of a reprieve, a little break from the sunshine. So if you're getting scalded out there in the open by the sun, come in here and you can just kind of escape from it a bit. The downside to areas like this would be mosquito heaven. This would be a nightmare in the wet season when the mosquitoes are out. Well, everything around here would be a nightmare in the wet season, but particularly places like this where they're protected from the wind, this is going to be the worst spot you could possibly be for mosquitoes. But right now, when the weather's nice like this and it's dry, I've only gotten a couple mosquito bites, so it's pretty nice. So it is the dry season, like I said, and we came into this thicket, this hammock of cypress, and there's no water here. However, this is absolutely 100% confirmed. This is where the lowest point is around here, and this is where standing water would be. But it's so dry that there's nothing, and you wouldn't think that not being able to find water or dehydration would be an issue in the Everglades, but this time of year, it certainly could be. There's no rain in the forecast, and there's no water to be seen anywhere around us. But if I take this stick and I plunge it down into the dirt, as far as it'll go, which is pretty far, when I pull it up, the end of that stick is really wet. So that tells me maybe that if I dig down here, I don't have a shovel or anything, so it might be kind of hard to dig, but maybe if I dig down here, I could create some sort of well, like a seep well of sorts. But look at this, watch. You see that? So the soil here is really wet. And now I'm not saying this is ideal, and I'm not saying that you'd want to drink this, but if your options were, you know, I've been 2 days without a drink of water and I'm stuck back here, I'm hurt maybe, I'm injured, and I've got no other options, then this might look a little bit more like the Fountain of Youth. All right, so I'm a good arm's length down, a couple feet for sure, and I've got water now. Maybe the easiest thing for me to do without like a giant big long straw or something would be just to take my shirt off, stick it down there, let it soak up the moisture, and then wring it out. I could do that potentially with just the soil. Put this soil in my shirt and then squeeze the shirt, wring it out, and get the moisture to drip out of it. It's not going to be pleasant. It's probably going to taste like mud.
My son, he can't, he's a boy 100% through and through, and he can't help himself. Like, he has to be breaking things, smashing stuff, whacking things with sticks all the time, constantly.
As I'm letting the water clear up in my water hole there, we'll discuss this. It's good to know the local area and the go-to tender sources. In Florida, South Florida, where we are right now, tender sources are pretty much everywhere. You can find them all over the place. But one of the really, really good ones is going to be this cypress bark. Cypress bark is really good for tender. This comes off in these huge, big strips. And then all you got to do is just rough it up a little bit. Don't even need nearly this much, like that much there is more than enough. And this, you can see how dry and dusty that is. This stuff, with just that little bit of processing, is just about the best tinder that you can get. That cypress bark there will take a coal from a primitive fire, it will take a spark from a ferro rod, a flick of the Bic, whatever, easily. So let's say I'm caught out here in the middle of this not so wet wetland, and I need to get my water out of here, and I don't have a canteen cup to dip down in there. I don't have a water filter, purification device, anything like that. I can probably find some trash still. There's trash everywhere. Luckily in this area, it's really pretty clean, which is nice. But if I could find myself a trash water bottle, cut up a t-shirt — this is not a t-shirt, but I could sacrifice my t-shirt if I wanted to — and wrap it over the end and give myself basically a pre-filter, and then I could submerge that. There's two layers of cloth here, which will keep most of at least the big particulates out, and I could submerge this down in my water hole, and we'll see what we come up with. Do this very gently. See what we can get. It actually doesn't smell. In a lot of other places where I've done this kind of technique, even at home in the mountains, Southern Louisiana in the swamp, when you dig into the soil, it smells like rotten vegetation, and it's pretty nasty. But here, it doesn't smell. There's almost, it's a very clean, kind of fresh smell to this hole that I've dug here, which is a little bit surprising. But that bodes well for me if I plan on drinking this water.
Got a little bit of water in there. I mean, if I set it in there and I did that for a long period of time, I could probably get that to fill up. If I stretched the t-shirt a little bit thinner, it would probably filter a little bit more, or filter a little bit less, but go a little faster. But I mean, it's a little bit muddy. Tastes a little like dirt, but it's really not that bad. It's not as bad as some of the water that I've done this with in other places. So it is a drink of water that's better than, a whole lot better than nothing. It's a lot better than dying of dehydration, that's for sure. So if you should find yourself in a not so wet wetland and during the dry season, lost, injured, whatever it may be, if you can find a low-lying area like this and dig down, you can find standing water like this that will see you through the short term. Yeah. All right, guys. As I wring out my my neck gaiter here, I really appreciate you tuning in for this little how to find some water in a not so wet wetland. Make sure you hit that thumbs up and subscribe if you haven't done so already, and we'll see you on the next one.